My name is Archie Hearn, Garbo. Hearn is my wife. This facility is Hearnes Center. This is Garbo's bookstore at Art Gallery. I have a physician's office next door, close coffee shop. But we're here today to recognize someone who I'm almost sorry that people don't know. I think people in the music world know this gentleman, Clark Terry. Phenomenal individual, phenomenal human being, phenomenal musician, phenomenal teacher. Encourage you to find out. Clark is from St. Louis. And I read the book recently, and I was almost ashamed that I didn't know some of the things that this man has accomplished over the years. I grew up in San Francisco, so we had our set of musicians that we were all excited about. But when I read the book, each and every musician that I knew about, Miles, Herbie Hancock, Corey Conner, James Moody, Sarah Vaughan, Ella Fitzgerald, Oscar Peterson, you go on and on and name any musician Clark has either played with, wrote for, taught, brought along. And this book is just incredible. I could put the book down for him. But Gwen, Clark's wife, is going to talk about the book. And she, I went to a book signing in Pine Bluff. It was really interesting. I was fascinated by some of the stories. But Gwen is going to really light this little session up, this book signing up, because she also brought some musicians, some of Clark's people he's played with, people he's taught. They're here. They're going to see him. Clark lives in Pine Bluff. I think he's at home now. He's in the hospital. Still in the hospital. And I have yet to personally see him, so I've got to get down there. So, Gwen, do you want to come to us?
Well, before I go and start talking about the book, I just want to thank God for all of you being here and for the opportunity to talk about Clark's book and for the special surprise blessing, which had I had no idea that Sylvia from radio. Oh, she's down here taking a picture. And all of these are Clark's quintet, personal quintet players, that I had no idea that they were going to be able to coordinate their schedules from Europe and Japan and Lubbock, Texas, and everywhere, wherever they are, to be able to come here today. They came to Pine Bluff to see Clark, who is, as Archie said, in the hospital, and we all want to ask your prayers for his recovery. But they have graced us today, a total surprise. And God even led me and Sherry, my friend here, who drove with me to find the keyboard. John Graham loaned us a bass. And these are some drums that Louis Belson gave to Clark from our home. So we have just been brought together with a collage of blessings from God. And they're going to play a couple of numbers for you just to give you a little flavor. And then we'll talk about the book, okay? So without further ado, Marcus McLaren on bass.
Wow.
And then Sung is a winner, one of the winners, and all of them are in the book. Helen is one of the winners from the International Thelonious Monk Piano Competition.
Wow. Yes. Nice.
Really big, stiff competition internationally. So she's going to play piano for us. And how long have you been playing with Clark?
The newest, maybe 5 or 6 years.
She's the newest one. So 5 or 6 years, and wait till you hear her play. And this is just a little cheap old piano, but she can make it sing, okay? And then Sylvia Cuenca, you'll read in the book, came just to sit in a little jam session at the Village Vanguard in New York. And Clark said when she walked up, he looked, because she's very attractive, as you'll see, and svelte. And he said, I wondered if she could really play some drums, because Clark is a serious musician. And he said when she sat down, and I'll let you read his comment in the book, okay? here's Sylvia. Sylvia, how long have you been playing with Clark?
17
years.
Wow. Yes.
Without further ado, part of Clark Terry's personal, adorable quintet, and here they are. Take away.
Wow. Yes.